Come and get a day. Ah! Everything we order from Sears and Robust. Just who is who or who is which? Won't it be rich when everyone's poor relative becomes a Rockefeller-tive and palms no longer itch? What a switch!
When we all have ermine and plastic teeth, how will we determine who's who underneath? And when all our neighbors are upper class,
let's toast the day we drink the drinky up, but with a little pinky up.
The day on which the idle poor become the idle rich.
When a rich man doesn't want to work, he's a bon vivant.
Yes, he's a bon vivant.
But when a poor man doesn't want to work, he's a loafer, he's a lounger, he's a lazy good for nothing.
He's a jerk.
When a rich man loses on a horse, isn't he the sport?
Oh, isn't he the sport?
But when a poor man loses on a horse, he's a gambler, he's a spender, he's a lowlife, he's a reason for divorce. When a rich man chases after dames, he's a man about town, a man about town. But when a poor man chases after dames,
he's a bounder, he's a rounder, he's a rotter, and a lot of dirty names.
You'll never know just who is which when the idle poor become the idle rich. When the idle poor become the idle rich. They're here! They're here! The sons of Gabriel blowing their horns of plenty. The angels of our new prosperity, Mr. Shears and Mr. Robust. Greetings, gentlemen. It's a pleasure to welcome you to Rainbow Valley.
Mr. McLonergan, we're not here on pleasure. We're here on business.
We got your letter, McLonergan. What do you mean you can't pay us for all those tractors and clothes he sent you?
I already explained that to you, because I can't dig up me gold.
Well, why not?
I'm surprised at you, gentlemen. Do you want to ruin free enterprise?
God forbid.
Well, what stimulates free enterprise? Incentive, right?
Right.
And what stimulates incentive? gold, right?
Right.
Well, if you remove the gold from the ground, then you remove incentive. And if you remove incentive, you wreck free enterprise. Right?
Right.
I rest my case.
There's just one thing that's not clear. How are you going to pay us for all this merchandise?
Gentlemen, suppose I do dig up me gold and give it to you. What will you do with it?
Send it to our bank in Chicago.
And what will they do with it?
Transfer it to our bank in Wall Street.
And what will they do with it?
Ship it to the Federal Reserve in Washington.
Now, gentlemen, tell me, what will the Federal Reserve do with it?
Bury it in Fort Knox.
That's me whole point. Me gold is already buried and near Fort Knox now.
And think of all the transportation Father is saving you.
We don't like it.
Why not?
It's un-American.
And we don't think you've got any gold.
Oh, what's the good of gold? Can't make music. Mm. Can't give milk.
Mm. It doesn't taste good with mustard.
We're not in the mustard business.
My God, we're dealing with a bunch of crackpots.
We'll have you blacklisted in every chamber of commerce in this country. We're pulling out all our equipment tomorrow. All of it.
Well, hang on. Don't be irritated. Have a lucky gold. Oh, well, that's no way to treat the Lucky Gold Company. They just gave me an order of 40,000 bales of tobacco. Rainbow Valley tobacco.
What would Lucky Gold want anything to do with a pendant outfit like you?
Well, you've heard of the Golden Christmas, the Golden Melanus, the Golden Goldenness of Lucky Gold, haven't you?
They've always claimed that.
Well, when they found out about the gold in our land, feeding our tobacco leaves, they realized it was true. And now, they're shouting it out in life. Look, click, slick, pick, and the Nicotine Digest.
Well, this order is all the gold mine anyone needs.
Good sound economics.
So, Rainbow Valley.
Oh, Woody, me boy. And Sharon, me darling. Me mission is accomplished now. Your rainbow is just around the corner. I'll be leaving soon, and it will be my lifelong dream to see you two married. But that's a decision no man should have to make for you. How would next Tuesday suit everyone for the wedding?
Father!
Then Tuesday it is, and you're all invited. Formal dress required.
Let's toast the day. The day we drink and drinking up, but with a little pinking up. The day on which the idol poor become the idol rich.
Where is he? Where's Senator Rawkins?
You got me, Beulah.
Well, I can't go and tell everybody he's resting at White Sulphur Springs.
Well, no one's seen him since the day he was struck by lightning.
The DA's raising a big stink, threatening indictments all over the place.
He just took to the hills and never came back. Well, you had something to do with it, you know.
Oh, that's poppycock talk, Beulah. Nobody did anything to Rawkins.
Well, there's 50 witnesses saw it happen. I suppose you get an eye, he turned dirt poor?
Well, no, but it ain't good poor. It's just bad dirt poor. Strawberries bring on hives, lack of money brings on jaundice. Anybody hates poor people like Rawkins does, it's triple jaundice.
Well, I don't know what you're talking about. All I know, she wished it, and it happened. Give it till Tuesday to produce the corpus, or you may have a murder rap in your hands. Come on, Beulah.
Put that in your guitar and plunk it. Well, do you really think I wish that on the senator?
Well, let's face it, Sharon. Ever since he came to Rainbow Valley, some strange things have been happening. You gotta admit that.
I've been worried about it myself.
Why, this whole town's been lousy with flying broomsticks. I felt it from the first time I looked at you.
Felt what, Woody?
Well, that sort of charm glitter in your eye, that conjured music in your voice. I've been bedeviled and bewitched ever since.
Then that settles everything. I couldn't possibly marry you.
Well, why not?
I wouldn't be a natural wife. Our children might have cloven hooves or two heads. You know, Father did always say there was something about McLonergan's.
Oh, and he was right. Isn't it true you voodooed me out of that trip to New York?
Did I do that?
And isn't it true you're standing there right now, gloating over my helplessness, making me putty in your hands, and sweep me off my feet?
Woody, this really is love, isn't it?
Shucks, no. It's just the moon in your eye, radiating incentive.
You and your glance make this romance too hot to handle. Stars in the night blazing their light can't hold a candle to your razzle-dazzle. You got me flying high and wide on a magic carpet ride full of butterflies inside. Wanna cry, wanna croon, wanna laugh like a loon. It's that old devil moon in your eyes.
Just when I think I'm free as a dove, old devil moon deep in your eyes blinds me with
Glacamora. Is that little brook still leaping there? Does it still run down to Donico, Lukili Banks, Kilkerry, and Kildare? How are things in Glacamora?
Give me that!
Well, no need to yell, mister. There's plenty of apples to go around.
Well, I don't see them.
Well, naturally you don't. Mortals can never see all the apples they could have. An apple here, an apple there, little red apples everywhere. Oh, my, you must be hungry. Would you care for a sandwich?
Well, you'd be hungry too if you've been hiding out in the woods for the past 2 weeks like a hunting possum.
Oh, what you hiding from?
Well, my wife, my friends, my family. You think I want them to see me like this?
Well, I see nothing wrong with you.
Well, you must be blind. Can't you see that I'm dirt poor?
Well, of course, and I think it's very becoming.
But I'm really a filthy rich man. Well, at least I was 2 weeks ago. A filthy rich man!
Well, that's a coincidence. I was green a few weeks ago. Don't you find the occasional change interesting?
No, I don't. And they won't get away with it. I tell you, they won't get away with it!
Well, no need to get so excited, mister. I think it's ridiculous to make such a fuss about anything.
You moron! Well, don't you know what it means to be dirt poor?
Well, you're still human. You can still smell bee honey and listen to bird music. A rose is still a rose, despite your shabby clothes.
Oh, why don't you go away?
Well, I think I know your problem. You're too unfriendly.
I'm in no condition for a friendship.
And it's all that witch's fault. She made you poor when she should have given you more. Very incompetent. It may set witchcraft back 100 years. This will give my whole profession a bad name.